Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Jaya Radha, Govinda Radha, Govinda Radha, Jaya Gaura Nithai, Jaya Gaura Nithai, Gaura Nithai, Jaya Gaura Nithai, Jaya Jagannatha, Jaya Baladeva, Subhadrama, Jaya Sudarshana, Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Nithai Gaura Haribol, 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 Haribol.
Thank you, Gaurav.
Thank you.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Okay. Om Gyanati Mirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Maritam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Namah Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasute Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisheshaya Shunyavadi Pashchata Deshatarine Jayo Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasati Gaura Bhaktivinoda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Okay, we continue reading Krishna book, Sunday serial.
Prabhu, in which chapter we are?
Rasalila, we are in the middle of Rasalila.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. Yes, Surnath Prabhu, are you able to read?
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Okay, we will read.
Okay, you tell as much because this is just no shlokas, nothing, only reading. Okay, we will keep discussing after one para we stop, we keep discussing. Okay, as far as I remember, we did till this much last time. Okay,
so we will start from Sukhdev Goswami.
Yeah, Sukhdev Goswami.
Hare Krishna. Sukhdev Goswami further concludes that the great sages and devotees who are washed clean of all conditional life can move freely even within the contamination of material nature by keeping Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, within their hearts. In this way, also they do not become subject to the laws of pleasure and pain in the modes of material nature. How then is it possible for Krishna, who appears in his own internal potency, to be subjected to the laws of karma?
Okay, so then this is a very nice argument, because if just by thinking about Krishna you become purified, then how can Krishna ever be impure? And a very good argument. Everybody understands this argument? Gaurav?
Yes, sir.
Shripad, Hare Krishna, welcome.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, how is your chanting going on?
Going on, but not well like before.
Your health is okay?
Yeah, Prabhuji.
Okay, health is okay, that's okay. So how is it possible then, this argument, very beautiful argument, just because of chanting Hare Krishna, if you purify, then how pure Krishna must be? Correct? That is an argument. Right. So that's a very beautiful argument. Just meditating on Krishna, I become free from all karma and we can go back to Krishna. How pure Krishna must be? Yes. So how can Krishna be subject to laws of karma? Yes, Prabhuji. I think we can continue. Yeah.
In the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord clearly says that whenever he appears, he does so by his internal potency. He is not forced to accept a body by the laws of karma like an ordinary living entity. Every other living entity is forced to accept a certain type of body by his previous actions. But when Krishna appears, he always appears in a body. It is not forced upon him by the action of his past deeds. His body is a vehicle for his transcendental pleasure, which is enacted by his internal potency. He has no obligation to the laws of karma. The Mayavadi monist must accept a certain type of body, being forced by the laws of nature. Therefore, his claim to be one with Krishna or God is only theoretical. Such persons who claim to be equal with Krishna and indulge in Ras Lila create a dangerous situation for the people in general. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is already present as super soul within the bodies of the gopis and their husbands. He is the guide of all living. Entities, as is confirmed in the Kathopanishad, Nityo Nityanam, Chetas, Chetanas, Chetananam. The super soul directs the individual soul to act, and the super soul is the actor and witness of all action.
It continues, this next paragraph is connected.
It is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita that Krishna is present in everyone's heart, and from him come all action, remembrance, and forgetfulness. He is the original person to be known by Vedic knowledge. He is the author of Vedanta philosophy, and he knows the Vedanta philosophy perfectly well. The so-called Vedantists and Mayavadis cannot understand Krishna as he is. They simply mislead followers by imitating the actions of Krishna in an unauthorized way. Krishna, the super soul of everyone, is already within the body of everyone. Therefore, if he seeks someone or embraces someone, there is no question of propriety.
Another argument. Oh, everybody got this argument. Krishna is anyway within the heart of everybody. Okay, now this argument we heard previously, that if you're thinking about Krishna, you become pure, then how pure Krishna must be. So now Krishna comes by the internal potency, and the Mayavadis who say that I am also Krishna and I will also enjoy Rasleela. First, he should agree he is not born by his own nature. Correct? He is not born by his choice. He is forced to take birth in a particular body. And it's, you know, highly foolish, this kind of an argument, that he will, he can also imitate Rasleela. Krishna, actually that's what we are all doing. We are trying to somehow imitate the dance of Krishna. We are also trying to create a dance in the middle. The Krishna is already present super soul in the heart. He is the guide of all the living entities. Yes. Krishna is present in everybody's heart. Sarvasya chaham, hridi sannivishto, mata smriti jnanam apohanam chadarsa shloka. He is original person, Vedic literature, Vedanta philosophy, Vedanta krita vede vedeva chaham. The so-called Vedantis, Mayavadis cannot understand Krishna as he is just simply misled. Yes. Already within the heart. So if he comes out and holds somebody's hand, where there is a question of difficulty for Krishna to do it. Krishna can anyway do it. And how it can be wrong. Actually, the body is owned by Krishna. Correct? In another way, if you look. Okay, this second argument is clear. Krishna is there within the heart of everybody as Paramatma. So he can always come out.
Some ask that if Krishna is self-sufficient, why should he at all manifest pastimes with the gopis, which are disturbing to the so-called moralists of the world? The answer is that such activities show a special mercy to the fallen conditioned souls. The gopis are also expressions of his internal energy, but because Krishna wanted to exhibit the Rasalila, they also appeared as ordinary human beings. In the material world, pleasure is ultimately manifested in the sex attraction between men and women. The man lives simply to be attracted by women, and the woman lives simply to be attracted by men. That is the basic principle of material life. As soon as these attractions are combined, people become more and more implicated in material existence. In order to show them a special favor, Krishna exhibited this Rasa-lila dance. It is just to captivate the conditioned soul. Since they are very much attracted by sexology, they can enjoy the same life with Krishna and thus become liberated from the material condition. In the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Maharaj Parikshit also explains that the pastimes and activities of Lord Krishna are medicine for the conditioned souls. If they simply hear about Krishna, they become relieved from the material disease. They are addicted to material enjoyment and are accustomed to reading sex literature. But by hearing these transcendental pastimes of Krishna with the gopis, they will be relieved from material contamination.
So this is one more reason. Then why did Krishna anyway do this pastime? Okay, he's not attracted to the gopis, but why did he, self-sufficient, why did he do this pastime? Actually, the special mercy for the conditioned soul. Why? Because this is a, you know, a dance between a boy and a girl, which people are very interested to read. Right? People are immediately get attracted to hear or see that. But when they hear this leela of the Lord with the gopis, the heart will be purified. Shanavatam Sakata Krishna, heart will be totally purified. And then what will happen? Next.
Hidayantastoya patrani vidhunoti suhrit satam.
And next. Nashta.
Nashta prahishu badrish.
Chantam
अनावृत्तं
स्थितं सत्वे प्रसीदति
देन एवम
एवम प्रसन्न मनसो भगवत भक्ति योगतः भगवत तत्व विज्ञानं
मुक्त संगत जायते Then, chidyate.
Chidyate hridaya granthihi vidyate sarva sanshayah.
Shriyante.
Shriyante tasya karmani drishtate atmani ishvare.
Very good, very good. So, she is also another dictionary, Shubha Mataji. So, what do we get here? So, this is that if you hear about Krishna pastimes, Krishna is mercy that he engages in this pastime with the gopis, because by seeing that we lose our attraction to the so-called base pleasures of this world and heart becomes purified. Yes, Surnath Prabhu, continue. Any comment, anybody? Anybody has any comment or a question till now? We continue.
How they should hear and from whom is also explained by Sukhdev Goswami. The difficulty is that the whole world is full of Mayavadis. And when they become professional reciters of Srimad Bhagavatam, and when people, without knowing the effect of the Mayavad philosophy, hear from such persons, they become confused. Discussion of Ras Leela among people in general is not recommended because they are affected by the Mayavad philosophy. But if one who is advanced explains and people hear from him, certainly the hearers will be gradually elevated to the position of Krishna consciousness and liberated from materially contaminated life.
Yeah, so nice. So you're hearing from Surnath Prabhu, you're all blessed. Liberated from the material contaminated life. Yes. So this is actually a mercy of Srila Prabhupada. He wrote this book, Krishna book. Prabhupada was very worried that he may not complete the Bhagavatam. And actually it does happen. Prabhupada does only finish the 10th canto, first volume, till four chapters. And had he Prabhupada not planned, we could not have the Krishna book, correct? And Prabhupada gave, it became an authorized book on Krishna Leela. Correct. So thank Prabhupada to have the foresight and think and write this book so that we all have, you know, authorized edition of Krishna. And Prabhupada also said many times, this is the number one book. When he was talking to George Harrison in the conversation, he asked, do you read any book? He said, I read the Krishna book. Prabhupada said, that's my number one book. So this is his most beautiful book. And Prabhupada also writes in the preface and introduction of this book that anybody reads this book will get Krishna Prema. That is a Shruti Phala he has blessed. So, Surnath Prabhu, we continue hearing. Anybody else has a question till now? I think all are wonderful devotees. There are no doubts. They are enjoying hearing. I can just clear with any new people. Let me ask. No, they are not new. All are wonderful devotees. But still. Shripad, any doubts?
I want to ask something.
No, Prabhuji.
Yeah. Chalo, yes.
I want to ask something.
Yeah.
What I want to ask is that it is said that we should not have sense gratification in our life, isn't it? We have to give it up.
Hmm.
But what happens is but if you give up all sense gratification then and you become depressed, then there is a risk of many diseases.
Okay. Yes, Shlomo Mataji, please answer.
We can dovetail everything to Krishna's devotional service. Any sense, all the senses we can engage in Krishna's services. So, for example, earlier means before coming to Krishna consciousness, we used to cook and we used to eat for our sense gratification. Now we can dovetail it, we can offer prasadam to, means bhog to Krishna and we can have. And whatever you want, maybe the you if you like shopping, you shop means shopping for Krishna, get some good dresses for Krishna, decorate Krishna deities, like that. Everything you can do in Krishna's service. If you sing Bollywood means songs, now you can sing kirtans, you can listen to kirtans, Vaishnava songs, like that. Each and everything Prabhupada has given the complete. It is complete package. You can get all the entertainment in Krishna service. Krishna consciousness. So there is no kind of means like we feel depressed. We will feel more happier. This so blissful. This Krishna consciousness is. There is no question of depression in Krishna consciousness.
Thank you, Mataji.
We can add anything.
No. Any other? Anybody has come from your this thing? Surnath Prabhu, you like to answer her question? She's saying we give up material pressure, then you get depressed. So, what do you like to say?
Actually, that's fortunately attached to Krishna, isn't it?
Yes, Surnath.
Yeah, if Krishna is in the center, like a normal person, we are getting up and getting clean, taking bath, making a food. Going to earn money. But if Krishna is in the center, the same things what normal people are doing. And if Krishna is in between, then we are getting cleaned or we are taking bath for the purpose of Krishna, to serve Krishna. We are cooking for Krishna. So if Krishna is in between, if you keep him in center, so automatically whatsoever we are doing every day-to-day activities, that becomes for Krishna. And so direction changes. So we do continue whatsoever we are doing, only we have to keep Krishna in the center. Other than the entertainment, if you are going to movie and other entertainment, those things naturally has to be restrained. Otherwise, normal day-to-day life has to continue. Just keeping Krishna in the center, things, direction will change.
Yeah, it automatically will be, means we will not have any material desires. Means automatically it will, we don't feel any taste in see watching movies and all. If we, means if we engage ourselves in Krishna's service and hearing Krishna Katha or Krishna's kirtans, we don't feel any taste in other things. We feel that what we were doing that was silly. we start feeling like that.
Yeah, that's true.
Pallavi, they're all powerful preachers. You know, I went to Salala there. 500 people are chanting there. 500.
Right.
Isn't it?
Yes.
The congregation is 500. And the Janmashtami time, I saw maybe 1,500 people come. And they cook for them. They serve them. They clean the place. Till Surnath Prabhu, I saw till 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock night. He was there.
Surnath Prabhu has got award the best BV leader from our Guru Maharaj.
Oh!
2018, I think. Yes, BV leader award Guru Maharaj gave him.
Very nice.
Hello. So, Pallavi, you got many friends now. Shava Mataji, yes. You take a number from me and you can keep in touch with her. She's a wonderful devotee.
It's there in Radha group. Okay, I will take.
Yeah, you keep in touch. Okay, I continue, Pallavi.
Yes, Prabhu.
Sripad, yes, Prabhuji, continue.
Another important point is that all the gopis who danced with Krishna were not in their material bodies. They danced with Krishna in their spiritual bodies. All their husbands thought that their wives were sleeping by their sides. The so-called husbands of the gopis were already enamored by the influence of the external energy of Krishna. So by dint of this very energy, they could not understand that their wives had gone to dance with Krishna. What then is the basis of accusing Krishna of dancing with others' wives? The bodies of the gopis, which were their husbands, were lying in bed, but the spiritual parts and parcels of Krishna were dancing with him. Krishna is the supreme person, the whole spirit, and he danced with the spiritual bodies of the gopis. There is therefore no reason to accuse Krishna in any way.
Oh my God. Now, if you add this reason, then nothing remains. Correct? Anna? Krishna is dancing with in the complete. Krishna is anyway full spirit, pure spirit. And Krishna doesn't have matter in his body. And is dancing with the spiritual bodies of the gopis. Then who has any right now to accuse anything? Therefore, these pastimes have to be properly understood through the Guru Parampara. Isn't it? Anna? Otherwise, people misunderstand. Okay, so we had so many reasons now, which were some we did last time, and today we did some reasons. Now we continue. Sripad, you had something? You had put your hand up, you wanted to ask something?
Yes, Prabhuji. Whatever I wanted to say, Shobha Mataji towards the end answered it, so there was no point in me telling it
again. Anyway, yes, what was the point?
I just wanted to tell that with the chanting, all these material desires come down. So when there is no desire, there is no question of suppression at all.
Mataji, he just came to temple some time ago. He cannot believe. And he started chanting 108 rounds every day.
It's only during this lockdown period, Prabhuji. I cannot continue it beyond this.
Oh, don't worry. We are continuing the lockdown for another 15 days probably. So you can do
it. It's really, really great, Prabhuji. 108.
You tell your Mataji, she will be very happy. Continue.
After the Rasa dance was over, the night turned into the Brahm Muhurta, the night of Brahma, a very, very long period, as mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. The Brahma Muhurta takes place about 1.5 hours before sunrise. it is recommended that one should rise from bed at that time and after finishing daily ablutions, take to a spiritual activity by performing Mangal Aratrika and chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. This period is very convenient for the execution of spiritual activities. When that auspicious moment arrived, Krishna asked the gopis to leave. Although they were not willing to quit his company, they were very obedient and dear to him. As soon as Krishna asked them to go home, they immediately left and returned home. Sukadev Goswami concludes this episode of Ras Lila by pointing out that if a person hears from the right source of the pastimes of Krishna, Vishnu himself and the gopis who are expansions of his energy, then he will be relieved from the most dangerous type of disease, namely lust. If one actually hears Ras Lila, he will become completely freed from the lusty desire of sex life and elevated to the highest level of spiritual understanding. Generally, because they hear from Mayavadis and they themselves are Mayavadis, people become more and more implicated in sex life. The conditioned soul should hear the Ras Lila dance from an authorized spiritual master and be trained by him so that he can understand the whole situation. Thus, one can be elevated to the highest standard of spiritual life. Otherwise, one will be implicated. Material lust is a kind of heart disease, and to cure the material heart disease of the conditioned soul, it is recommended that one should hear, but not from the impersonalist rascals. If one hears from the right sources with right understanding, then his situation will be different.
Okay. So we should hear from the right source. This is very important. Bhagavad Gita also Krishna says, Tashnu, hear from me. Maya sakta mana partha yogam yunjam madashayaha asamshayam samagramam shagyasati tashnu. Hear from me. We hear from Krishna or his devotees, then we get an actual picture. So we will become free from the biggest problem is actually the stupid sex life, correct? Attraction to enjoying, dominating another living entity, you know, in gross way sex life. So we get free from this tendency. Material lust is the kind of a disease. Prabhupada said it's a disease. And it's not easy to cure this disease. But recommended one should hear, but not from impersonalism. Right source and the right understanding, his situation will be different.
It is said that Avaishnavam Mukhodgirnam Putam Harikathamritam Ravanev Kartavyo Sarpochishti Yathapayam, isn't it?
What does it mean?
It means that from the non-devotee, the very pure Harikatha, you should not hear. You should never hear. Because the effect is like Sarpochishti. It means milk is there, but it has been touched by serpent, so it has become poisonous.
Correct. So we cannot cheat the process. That's why it is very important. Just like now we are reading the Krishna book. Okay. Now we can bring an orator. You heard the orators which orate in documentaries or movies. They have such beautiful voice. But if you hear them, Krishna, just like we are asking Surnath Prabhu to hear because it's a devotee. We want to hear from him. But suppose we ask the orator to read this. I tell you, it will destroy our spiritual life because he has no faith in what he's reading. You understand, Shobha Mataji? Correct?
Yes, Prabhu. Yes,
like temple also we have kirtan. We can get a great artist to sing, but if he's not a devotee, if he's not following devotional principles, this will destroy our spirit. Because we cannot play with the process. It's a transcendental phenomena. See, these are all in a paper ink. What is it? One level, it's just ink on a paper. Correct? What we are reading. The next level, what is it? It is some words which are has, you know, some arrangement of some symbols, which you call a language. Next level, if you see, it is, has some grammar and we can read, it has some meaning, correct? It is still material. But then, when it is the words of pure devotee and read by a devotee, and then it takes a spiritual power. We cannot cheat the process. The process, you understand? No? Just like you said, this is prasadam. But if it is not made by a devotee, if it is not offered a devotion to the Lord, it is not a prasadam. We cannot cheat the process. So, not from, correct? The process, we cannot make joke of the process. The process works when it is properly done. A devotee has written the book, a devotee reads it, and we hear his submission. Process acts. Correct? And it gives us the processes. Okay, is it fine, Pallavi? What you are saying, correct? It adds to this. Correct? The process works when devotees are involved.
Prabhupada has said that Bodhayastas Parasparam.
Machitta.
Kata prana bodhayanta parasparam katayantaschamam nityam tushyanti charamanti.
That's what is happening now. Correct? Tushyanti, everybody is delighting, enjoying. Yes. Okay. Any other question? Rohan, is it fine? Chalo, Vikas has a question. We will ask now. With one more page, we'll get over Vikas, then we'll ask. Shripad, somebody has a question. How do you manage to chant 108 rounds?
It simply happens. If you ask me how, I do not know. You just make the sankalpa and Krishna will make it happen. That's it.
Vikas, got the answer? Yes. Chalo, continue.
Sukhdev Goswami has used the word Shraddhanvita for one who is trained in the spiritual life. Shraddha or faith is the beginning. One who has developed his faith in Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Supreme Spirit Soul, can both describe and hear. Sukhdeva also uses the word anusrunyat. One must hear from cyclic succession. Anu means following, and anu means always. So one must always follow the disciplic succession and not hear from any stray professional reciter, Mayabadi or ordinary man. Anusrunyat means that one must hear from an authorized person who is in the disciplic succession and is always engaged in Krishna consciousness. When a person wants to hear in this way, then the effect will be sure. By hearing Ras Lila, one will be elevated to the highest position of spiritual life.
Okay, now let us make. When a person wants to hear from the Guru Parampara, okay? Anu always means following. Anu means always. Correct. Anusaran. And always follow the discourses, not hear from any stray professional reciter, Mayavada, ordinary man. Okay? Let us not cheat the process. Always hear from somebody who has taken shelter of the Vaishnavas in the Guru Parampara. Anushunyat means one who hears from authorized person, always engage in Krishna consciousness. Yes. Before we hear from him, we should see what he does other time. Say, speaking is easy. Half an hour, we can speak big things. Then another 23 and a half hour, what the person is doing, we should watch. Then hear him. Correct? You understand this point? So when a person wants to hear in this way, then the effect will be sure. By hearing Rasalila, will be elevated to the highest position of spiritual life. Any questions here? No. Chalo, continue.
Prabhuji, I have a question here.
Yeah.
Prabhuji, for example, now, since I'm not initiated or something, so other than Krishna consciousness parampara, wherein all the Gurujis are like Maharaj are there, for example, even in Iyengar, for example, we hear lots of Bhagavatam and all. For example, Vishakha Hari, some other famous people who come under the same parampara. So, can we hear of their Bhagavatams also, apart from Krishna consciousness parampara guru system?
Okay. See what happens. There are two aspects of this. One thing is the Sri Vaishnava is the bona fide sampradaya. Okay, we have all honor. We should have all the honor. Okay, is it fine? So there is no issue in that respect. But then when it comes to finally conclusion, we choose a parampara. And then sampradayas don't mix. You got it? Just like say, you are studying in, you want to study medicine. Huh? Mm-hmm. You have to choose a college which you want to choose. You can choose, say, Mangalore, you can choose the Manipal group, KMC, or you can choose the Nitya group, correct? So once you get admitted to the particular group, you have to follow that rules and regulations.
Yeah, I understand. But for example,
there will be certain difference of the rules and regulations. And because this philosophy is Vishishta Advaita, this is
Achinda Veda Veda, there will be slight difference, just like there will be no discussion of Radha Krishna Leela as it is discussed in this Achinda Veda Tattva. It's only Gaudiya Vaishnavas recognize Radha Krishna Leela. Shri Vaishnavas don't recognize. You understand? So okay. you have to make a decision one day which sampradaya you want to follow. You got it?
Okay.
You got it? Because yeah. The conclusions will be slightly different. That is one point. So generally, if somebody is intelligent, he can also understand one thing. That all the four sampradayas were merged by Lord Chaitanya into Achinda Veda Veda Tattva. Correct? Madhvacharya gave Dvaita Dvaita. Then we have the Vishishta Dvaita. All the sampradayas are mixed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu into Achinda Veda Veda, which is actually the final truth. Okay? So if a person is intelligent, this is because coming from Lord Chaitanya, who has synthesized all the four sampradayas into one. Person can take to Lord Chaitanya's conclusion, which we are studying. Okay, it makes sense, Chaitanya?
Yes, yes. We are talking about conclusion is to follow Gaudiya.
Automatically, yeah. Automatically, Ramanujacharya will be very, very happy. You don't have to have, because see, many devotees in ISKCON are from Sri Sampradaya and they're very happy. Very, very happy. One of the devotees who made me devotee is from Sri Sampradaya. He is Rasaraj Prabhu. He's the head of the BI, Bhaktananda Institute in Bombay. Correct? And there was one more, I remember one devotee was there. His father, he had joined. His father was a Sri Vaishnavan. He used to come to temple and, you know, tell us so many stories of, you know, when we travel, sometimes we travel to Sri Rangam, we travel to Tirupati, correct? We do hear. We enjoy hearing all the wonderful pastimes of Ramanujacharya. All that is fine, that we enjoy relishing. But as far as our Siddhanta is concerned, details, we stick to Achinda Veda Veda. Okay?
Okay. Thanks, Prabhu.
See, suppose you got too much details, you'll find there are some difference in the conclusions. Therefore, we stick to one party. So it is good to, I feel it is mature to stick to Lord Chaitanya's party because it is the latest. You see, recently he has come and the Sampradaya has been coming, all the exalted acharyas after that. Madhvendrapuri was there before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then we had the Goswamis. Oh, it's amazing. It's amazing. So no way you will be, and all of them participate in Lord Chaitanya's Leela. And Lord Chaitanya Leela was there, Ramanujacharya personally came in his Leela. Okay?
Yeah, I agree on that. Okay.
And there is one more thing. All the four Acharyas met Lord Chaitanya also. Okay? Interesting. They were delegated a particular task. They went to meet Lord Chaitanya and they were given a particular task and they have participated in the mission. And particularly, as far as my limited understanding goes, Ramanujacharya has explained everything, but more focus was on Dasaras. Because he was focusing on Narayana Vaikuntha, correct?
Mm-hmm.
But here, this Madhurya Rasa, this stage, and now we're reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, even much more detail, is speciality of this Gaudiya Sampradaya.
Okay, thanks, Prof. Yeah.
Okay, as far as delicately I can do, there's Sri Vaishnavas are highly respected Sampradaya, it's a bona fide Sampradaya. Prabhupada does quote in his books many times from Ramanujacharya, Yamunacharya, Sri Vigra, so many of the acharyas from Alwars, he keeps quoting. Kulushekar Avala, he has even written a book.
Alwars.
Prabhupada, you know, happily quoted. Even Nam Alwar, we know all these are very, very exalted devotees who came from Vaikuntha. Right?
Yes, yes.
We should have all respect for the Sampradaya. Okay.
Sukhdev Goswami uses two specific words. Bhaktim and Param. Bhaktim Param means execution of devotional service above the neophyte stage. Those who are simply attracted to temple worship but do not know the philosophy of bhakti are in the neophyte stage. That sort of bhakti is not the perfectional stage. The perfectional stage of bhakti or devotional service is completely free from material contamination. The most dangerous aspect of contamination is lust or sex life. Bhaktim Param, devotional service, is so potent that the more one advances in this line, the more he loses his attraction for material life. One, he is actually deriving benefit from hearing Rasa Leela dance, surely achieves the transcendental position. He surely loses all traces of lust in his heart.
Haribo. So you keep hearing Rasa Leela and you become totally free from lust in the heart. I had a simple understanding of this because this is real love. What goes out in gopis and Krishna is real love.
And what is there in this word, we can see it is not love, it is lust. Correct? So when you see real love, so-called love which goes in the name of, so-called lust which goes in the name of love is detected and thrown away. Correct? You don't feel interested in that. Isn't it? This logically it works like this, Shobha Mataji?
Yes, yes, Prabhuji.
Correct? In this world, what goes on in the name, pyar ho gaya, mohabbat, all the songs, we laugh, isn't it? As devotees, when we hear that, we laugh. Because you know where is real love now. Right? You're yes. not interested in that. Because you're seen in Krishna and the gopis real love. Any comments on this? Sushmita, Vikas, Kamlesh, Shisha, Dr. Shisha has come. Hare Krishna, Dr. Ji.
No problem.
Ah, no comments?
No.
Chalo, continue.
Srila Biswanath Chakravarti Thakur points out that according to Bhagavad Gita, the Brahma day and Brahma night are periods of solar years expanding to 4.3 million. Multiplied by 1,000. According to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, the Ras dance was performed during the long period of Brahma's night. But the gopis could not understand that in order to fulfill their desire, Krishna extended the night to cover such a great period of time. One may ask how this was possible. And Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur reminds us that Krishna, although bound by a small rope, could show his mother the whole universe within his mouth. How was this possible? The answer is that he can do anything for the pleasure of his devotees. Similarly, because the gopis wanted to enjoy Krishna, they were given the opportunity to associate with him for a long period. This was done according to his promise. When Krishna stole the garments of the gopis while they were taking bath at Chirghat on Yamuna, Krishna promised to fulfill their desire in some future night. In one night, therefore, they enjoyed the company of Krishna as their beloved husband, but that night was not an ordinary night. It was a night of Brahma and lasted millions and millions of years. Everything is possible for Krishna, for he is the supreme ruler. Thus ends the Bhakti Vedanta purport of the 32nd chapter of Krishna, description of the Rasa dance.
The green. Yes. Shobha Mataji, read that green line. The answer is that?
The answer is that he can do anything for the pleasure of his devotees.
So nice, huh? Krishna can do anything. The gopis were not satisfied after 4.3 billion years of dancing. Just imagine. And it is going on. Eternally, they are dancing with Krishna and they are not satisfied. Another, more they want to dance, more they want to dance. Mother Yashoda is playing with Krishna. She is not satisfied since eternity. The gopas are playing with Krishna since eternity. They are not getting bored. Correct? We watch a cricket match, you get bored in 10 minutes. And here, trillions of years, they are playing. They are having also a match, but they can never get bored. They still want to play more and more. In fact, it is said in the night is artificially created in the spiritual world. And they are waiting because spiritual world is all effulgent. And in the morning time, they're waiting at the door. The body doesn't get tired because it's a spiritual body. And they're waiting at the door. And Mother Yashoda is dressing. And some get so impatient, they come running inside the house and they dress Krishna and they drag him away. We see that picture? They can't wait for Mother Yashoda to finish the dress. They come and Krishna come and they're gone. So it's full of pleasure. Kevala Ananda Kanda. So you want to go to the spiritual world to dance eternally with Krishna, or you want to be in the middle world and create your own dance? Yes, Prajesh, what do you want to do?
Yeah, Prabhuji, I want to go to the spiritual world and dance.
Very well. Mataji is very just newly, he has come few days, he has understood Krishna consciousness. Anybody has said few days with Prabhupada, say, I want to go back to the spiritual world. He is, I think, the youngest boy now in our this group. He is at PU, PU college study.
Oh, maybe he is continuing from previous birth.
Oh, yes, of course, of course.
Yeah, from previous birth, he is continuing. Otherwise, it's not that easy to understand Krishna consciousness.
Not only that, I want to go back to the spiritual world and dance with Krishna. Yes. And Prabhupada was being in Rath Yatra in America. So he started laughing in the Rath Yatra time. And then they asked Prabhupada, Prabhupada, why are you laughing in the middle? He said, because Narada had come and Narada was laughing. Seeing him, I was laughing. Narada was seeing how the hippies are dancing in pleasure of Krishna consciousness. Correct? So this is the night of billions of years, or whatever. It's so such massive night, still not satisfied. And we can understand it's not difficult because spiritual world, they are dancing since eternity. And they're not satisfied. They still want to dance with Krishna more. Ananda Ambudi Vardhanam. The key is increasing. Everything is same in the spiritual world. I was telling this. Shripad Mataji comes as a journalist. He's a journalist, actually, young boy. He's a journalist. I was one day explaining to him the difference between news of the material world and news of the spiritual world. Because material world, everything is, you know, temporary, as boring. And everything happens today. So this many people died here, this many people died here, this bomb blast happened here, earthquake. Already suffering was not enough. Delhi had an earthquake today. See the dance of Kali Yuga. So anyway, so all this is going on. And you keep reporting, this happened. But the spiritual world, if you go with this kind of outlook, you're not going to take any notes. Because nobody is born there. Nobody dies there. That nothing like this happened. No earthquake happened. No, you know, virus come. Nothing. Everything looks same. But what is changing there? The love is increasing every day. Anna? Same Mother Yashoda plays with same Krishna every day. And the pleasure increases. Pleasure increases. The love increases. Because the love increases, the happiness increases. Isn't it?
Yes.
Somebody can explain more? Surnath Prabhu?
No, Prabhu, you have explained completely.
No, I'm just looking from a journalist point of view. He will not be able to write anything there. Because same thing. Therefore, people find very boring. What's the same thing? Huh? Actually, if you go to spiritual world now, you'll be bored. Same thing. Huh? Same kirtan every day, same mangalarti, nothing. Huh? Therefore, you know, Prabhupada talked about a priest went to a coal mine. And you heard that Prabhupada takes an example and starts laughing. And he tells the miners that if you pray to Jesus, otherwise you go to hell. He said, what is hell? It's a damn dark place. They look at each other because they're working in a mine. It's all damn dark place. They were not really, really excited. Anyway, we are in hell. Then he said, there is no newspaper there. Oh, no newspaper. Huh? Horrible. People are so attracted to the news of this world. What happened there? What happened there? Every day they get up, first they open, you know, the newspaper or the computer and see what happened. What happened? Right? In the spiritual world, these kind of things are not there. There is nothing. In fact, once they asked Srila Prabhupada that we can open a telegram. You know, telegraph was there previously. There was no like this facility like today, computer. So they opened a telegraph facility between a temple and Dai Nippon in Japan, where they can, you know, they can send letters purport or something directly to him. Chuck in a second it reaches there. So they asked Prabhupada between all temples also we can put on so that, you know, they can share. So Prabhupada said very interestingly, what is there to share? Mangalarti happened. Mangalarti happened. What is there to share? He started laughing. You got it? Then Prabhupada said, simply you will gossip, not needed. You know, simply they'll gossip that, you know, this person said this thing today, you know, this person left today, this person shouted. Simply you start gossiping, not needed. So you should understand spiritual world, there is Navanavarasa. Every moment there is expanding of the pleasure of serving Krishna. The ocean of love of Krishna is shaking in the spiritual world. And there was once one devotee, he went to meet Lord Chaitanya from Mayapur, he came. I think his name is Pradyumna Mishra. And he went to Lord Chaitanya and he said that, please teach him about Krishna. Chaitanya said, go to Ramananda Rai, he will teach you. And he went to Ramananda Rai. And Ramananda Rai was very busy arranging the girls for dancing for Jagannath Vallabha Nataka. He just could not understand it. And he came back to Lord Chaitanya. Chaitanya said, don't worry, he's a pure devotee of Krishna. His mind is not shaken, it's like a wood. Even though he's, you know, encouraging them to dance, you know, specific dance for the pleasure of the Lord, you know, his mind is pure. The next day he came, so Ramananda Rai said, I'm very sorry, yesterday I was busy, I could not meet you. He said, please tell me something about Krishna.
And Ravana the Raya starts speaking. And Chaitanya Charitamrita says, when he spoke, the ocean of love of Krishna started shaking. So that what happens when Prabhupada was speaking, ocean love of Krishna was shaking. You know, you see people hearing Prabhupada classes, their eyes are so fixed on Prabhupada. Have you seen that videos? And to this day, 50 years, their life, they cannot forget Prabhupada. Just they may be seen Prabhupada for half an hour, 10 minutes. It's totally shaken up. Ocean of love of Krishna was shaken.
Prabhuji, here I have one doubt. Krishna extended one night for 43 lakhs of years.
4.3 billion into 1,000 it is. Yeah.
Okay. Means it's in Dwapara Yuga he extended this, or it is eternal?
Now you don't make more calculation because it is beyond your conception. You will say Dwapara Yuga became bigger than so many calculations. Don't make. Because understand Krishna stopped time. That's it.
Okay. It's eternally actually. It is not, means we cannot calculate it according to the yuga.
Then you will be like, then you are saying that Krishna was born not 5,000 years ago. Then we have to add 8.6, 4.3 billion years plus 5,000, isn't it?
Yes.
That dance is in spiritual platform, not in this one.
Even you go to Seva Kunj, all these look very Nidhivan, all look very small place because there were thousands of gopis dancing.
The spiritual bodies.
This is not there. Huh? Who had come with us is not there. So we had just recently gone. No. Kamalesh Prabhu, you were there this time? No. Vrindavan?
No problem. No problem.
Okay. So anyway, because they are dancing here in the Sivan in the spiritual bodies, you know, correct? It's an important spiritual dimension. You know? What do you say, Shisha? Places look very small actually. If you see where the Krishna was blowing the flute, what is the place called? Where Krishna blew the flute to bring all the gopis. What they call?
Nidhivan?
No, Nidhivan. Shisha, what is the place Krishna blows a flute?
This is Tirthadamba.
Yeah. So if you go all those places, they don't look very big, you know, they look very small. But they are in the spiritual plane. All is happening on a spiritual plane. And not one, thousands of gopis are there. And there's unlimited rasa. And now how many gopis? Some calculation thousands, some calculation millions. Isn't it, Shisha?
Yeah. And one point I have to say,
you first answered Mataji's question. Krishna was born now 5,000 years ago, or 4.3 billion years plus 5,000?
No, that's what I already told. That is in the spiritual. That is spiritual. The bodies were totally spiritual. That spiritual dance was taking place.
Yes. After that night, again gopis came back to Vrindavan, right? The next day. Means they were in Vrindavan.
And their husbands, how they lived that much time, their husbands? 4.3 billion years, they slept for 3.3 billion years.
They did not come to know that much time. It is Achintya, that is what it is.
Achintya. Their bodies were there only.
Their bodies were there only, yes. And Krishna stopped the time. Krishna stopped the time, correct? Kala Chakra is in Krishna's hand, isn't it? See, Kala, what is Kala finally? Kala is not the time in your watch. Now quantum physics can come in. Kala is, the force which makes things degrade. Kala is not time of the watch. Kala is the force which causes everything to destruction. So Kala was stopped by Krishna. Correct? Kala yes. Chakra. You remember we used to see this nonsense serial Mahabharata, and this, before that Kala Chakra used to come. If you all remember.
Yes.
Though the idiots, at least one thing was correct. This Kala Chakra. Krishna stopped the Kala Chakra.
Jayadratha's incident also, Krishna.
Which incident?
Yes.
Oh, Krishna killed that devotee person, no? Who had killed Abhimanyu, correct? Who is responsible Abhimanyu.
This Arjuna wanted to kill Bhishma once. So better no, I mean we should don't try to understand Krishna, just love him. If you try to understand him, he'll be confused.
But the point what you have read is this one, that green line. He can do anything for the pleasure of his devotees. Correct?
Yes. Please.
And he can go to any extent. Any extent, yes. Krishna can go to please his devotees. So he's fit to be the master. Always remember, Krishna is fit to be the master. You see, in the Vrindavan Leela, none of them know Krishna has the powers. But seeing his qualities, they just love him. Many people approach Krishna because of his power. You know, God is for the generator, operator, destroyer, and therefore they love God. We don't love God because of that only. Rishoda mother is actually not interested. That is the reason to love him. His qualities are so wonderful. Look at his quality now. Look at the quality, guys. There are 64 qualities of Krishna discussed in the Nectar of Devotion. So wonderful qualities, correct? But that's why they love Krishna. And here is one quality. You can do anything for the pleasure of Krishna.
Yes,
and
he was
fit to be the master. Yes. He's fit to be served.
Correct? He was ready to do any menial service for the sake of devotees. One incident is that he was ready to wash the feet of the guests doing Rajasuya Yaga when Yudhishthira Maharaja was doing. He accepted that menial service to wash the feet of the guests, the devotees. That is also one of his
opulences.
Yes, yes.
Where I get.
Yes, sir.
About this one, Sri Vaishnavas, Yamanacharya Sloka, Vedavadi Mama Cheta, Krishna Pada Ravinda, Namanamara Rasadam, Rantamasi, Tadavadi Pata Sahari Sangha, Krishna Nishtimanancha. This is from the Sri Shanta.
Beautiful sloka. Yadavadi Mama Krishna Chupadara Vinde, we should cram the shloka. He said, whenever I think of Krishna's lotus feet, Navanavarasa, so much pleasure I am getting every moment, that if I think about the Sangama, association of the woman, I spit at that thought, correct? This is a great shloka of Yamunacharya. Okay, tell us more. Sri Sampradaya, what Prabhupada quotes. Kulashekara Alva, about the lotus.
Yeah.
What is the shloka?
Krishna todiya pada pankaja pandarandam adyame vishnu manasa rajahamsa prana prayana samaye kapha vata bitte kanta varodana vada pranam kutasti.
Pallavi, you don't know this?
I will learn now.
Yes, it's a beautiful shloka. What is the meaning of the shloka?
That
what is the meaning of the shloka, Shisha? Explain.
At the death time, the throat will be choked by mucus.
Yeah.
He is praying that let me die early, young. Correct?
Immediately when I am hearing that Krishna Katha, that my soul will be held in that lotus when it is closing, and like it should close inside, and bee closing inside the lotus at the night, and it is like otherwise, you know, when the old age. You cannot, we are with the kapha vata pitta. You cannot chant. How can you chant the name of Lord at that time?
Yeah, but only throat is choked up, yeah, by all the infections, correct? Any other Sri Vaishnava sloka?
I think here the analogy of the Hamsa is given.
Yes.
The Hamsa is always engaged in the stem of the lotus.
Yes.
His complete attention is in the stem of the lotus. Similarly, the shloka says, my mind, let it be like a Hamsa, and it must be engaged all the times, eternally, within the lotus feet of the Krishna. So,
even in the old age when we'll be like choked up with Vata Pitta Kapha, then nothing of this will disturb us while remembering Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Any other question? We have finished, or you want me to go to the next chapter? We have some time, we can read.
I wish up next chapter pe chale jaye Prabhuji. I really wish ki hum kar le thoda sa.
Chalo Surnath Prabhu, we still have 20 minutes. We can read the small chapter, I think. Yeah, this is one pastime, at least some pastime we can do. Anybody has any other question here? Sushmita Mataji, Vikas, Sri Ram, Rohan, Radha Mataji.
No, I just want to say
that
in one place, Prabhupada has said that simply we have to become one of the Gopi Janas, then the Krishna will lift also a mountain in order to save us.
Yes. Krishna will do anything to protect a devotee, including lifting a mountain. Yes, thank you, Pallavi. Thank you.
But Prabhuji, aspire to become devotees, means is that desire is okay? Because we are conditioned souls, whereas the gopis, they are highly, this one, elevated souls. They are all...
I know that we can qualify, Mataji. We can say, okay, servant of the gopis.
Yes.
Correct. Prabhupada says sometimes don't try to even think becoming a gopi. You think becoming servant of the gopis. That's okay. Correct.
Yes.
We can add one detail there. Okay, 33rd. Vidyadhara liberated and the demon Shankasura killed. Yes, Prabhuji, Surnath Prabhu.
Once upon a time, the cowherd men of Vrindavana, headed by Nanda Maharaj, desired to go to Ambikavan to perform the Shivratri performance. The Raslila was performed during the autumn, and after that, the next big ceremony is Holi, or the Dol Yatra ceremony. Between the Dol Yatra ceremony and the Ras Lila ceremony, there is one important ceremony which is called Shivaratri, which is especially observed by the Sevites or devotees of Lord Shiva. But sometimes the Vaishnavas also observe this ceremony because they accept Lord Shiva as the foremost Vaishnava. But the function of Shivaratri is not observed very regularly by the Bhaktas or devotees of Krishna. Under the circumstances, it is stated in Srimad Bhagavatam that the cowherd men headed by Nanda Maharaj once upon a time desired. That means that they were not regularly observing the Shivaratri function, but that once upon a time they wanted to go to Ambikavan out of curiosity. Ambikavan is situated somewhere in the Gujarat province. Ambikavan is said to be situated on the river Saraswati. Yet we do not find any Saraswati river in the Gujarat province. The only river there is Sabarmati. In India, all the big places of pilgrimage are situated on nice rivers like the Ganges, Yamuna, Saraswati, Narmada, Godavari, Kaveri, etc. Ambikavan was situated on the bank of Saraswati, and all the cowherd men and Nand Maharaj went there.
Okay. See, it was intelligent to live on the bank of the river because one of the biggest problems of life is water. Water is needed. So all the civilizations were always on the banks of the river. Saraswati, everybody knows presently, has become invisible because the tributaries shifted here and there, and they have even satellite photographs to show that river Saraswati has become invisible. Have you seen that? Anybody has seen a documentary on that?
Yes.
Okay, chalo, we continue.
They very devotedly began to worship the deity of Lord Shiva and Ambika. It is the general practice that wherever there is a temple of Lord Shiva, there must be another temple of Ambika or Durga, because Ambika is the wife of Lord Shiva and is the most exalted of chaste women. She doesn't live outside the association of her husband. After reaching Ambikavan, the cowherd men of Vrindavan first bathe themselves in the river Saraswati. If one goes to any place of pilgrimage, his first duty is to take a bath and sometimes to shave his head. That is the first business. After taking bath, they worship the deities and then distributed charity in the holy places.
Today, this doesn't happen, correct? Bathing. But generally, you see in the holy places, there will be a Kalyani. Even in Tirupati, there is a Kalyani. You see, all the, even Udupi, there is a Kalyani. But previously, I think that is what purpose. People come, they come walking actually all the way. Is it previously? They take bath, freshen up, Anna. They even fast for a day. And then they give charity to the local brahmanas there. Yes, continue.
According to the Vedic system, charity is given to the brahmanas. It is stated in the Vedic Shastras that only the brahmanas and the sannyasis can accept charity. The cowherd men from Vrindavana gave cows decorated with golden ornaments and beautiful garlands. The brahmanas are given charity because they are not engaged in any business profession. They are supposed to be engaged in brahmanical occupations as described in the Bhagavad Gita. Namely, they must be very learned and must perform austerity and penances. They must not only themselves be learned, but they must also other brahmanas are not meant to be brahmanas alone. They should create other brahmanas also. If a man is found who agrees to become a brahmana's disciple, he is also given the chance to become a brahman. The brahmana is always engaged in the worship of Lord Vishnu. Therefore, the brahmans are eligible to accept all kinds of charity. But if the Brahmans receive excess charity, they are to distribute it for the service of Vishnu. In the Vedic scripture, therefore, one is recommended to give in charity to the Brahmans, and by so doing, one pleases Lord Vishnu and all the demigods.
Okay. So, patana patana yajana yajana dana pratigraha. Okay? These are the system of, that's why when you go to dham any time, the pandas are there, I'm a Brahmin, give me charity. Brahmanas don't ask. That is one qualification. They'll not give me charity. Give me, they don't bug like that. They do their service and people voluntarily give. Isn't it Shisha? Correct?
Yeah.
Very dignified way. Remember, we go to Govardhan Parikrama, we always meet one panda at Kusum Sarovar, correct?
Yeah,
he never asked charity, correct?
Yeah.
And basically, you will explain. That's a panda. Actually, pandas have a role to play in a dham. Because how do people understand? We don't want to know the Leela of Kusum Sarovar. They explain, we feel so happy, right? And then we give some donation. That is the way it is. But they demand, it's a horror. Then it becomes horror. Then we don't feel like going on. Prabhupada said they make a holy place unholy by their presence. I think everybody has an experience of that, particularly in North India. South India is different. South India temples give. Anna?
Yeah.
Like in Mangalore, temples are giving. Now temples don't know what to do. They were feeding 1,000 people every day. Nobody's coming now. Anna?
Yeah.
In fact, that was a very good system because nobody would starve them. All the cities, they have temples and temples are open. Langar. Anybody can come and have prasadam. There is no question of starvation. There is no need of a hotel. You go to any city, go to a temple and have prasadam. Anna? Isn't it?
Yeah.
There were no hotels at that time. Temples are there. And people are also going and they understand. They participate in the temple function.
The pilgrims take bath, worship the deity and give in charity. They are also recommended to fast one day. They should go to a place of pilgrimage and stay there at least for 3 days. The first day is spent fasting and at night they can drink a little water because water doesn't break the fast. The cowherd men, headed by Nanda Maharaj, spent that night on the bank of the Saraswati. They fasted all day and drank a little water at night. But while they were taking their rest, a great serpent from the nearby forest appeared before them and hungrily began to swallow up Nanda Maharaj. Nanda began to cry helplessly. My dear son, Krishna, please come and save me from this danger. This serpent is swallowing me. When Nanda Maharaj cried for help, all the cowherd men got up and saw what was happening. immediately took up burning logs and began to beat the snake to kill it. But in spite of being beaten with burning logs, the serpent was not about to give up swallowing Nanda Maharaj. At that time, Krishna appeared on the scene and touched the serpent with his lotus feet. Immediately upon being touched by the lotus feet of Krishna, the serpent shed its reptilian body and appeared as a very beautiful demigod named Vidyadhara. His bodily features were so beautiful that he appeared to be worshipable. There was a luster and effulgence emanating from his body, and he was garlanded with a gold necklace. He offered obeisances to Lord Krishna and stood before him with great humility. Krishna then asked the demigod, "You appear to be a very nice demigod and to be favored by the goddess of fortune. How is it that you perform such abominable activities, and how did you get the body of a serpent?" The demigod then began to narrate the story of his previous life. "My dear Lord," he said, "in my previous life, I was named Vidyadhara and was known all over the world for my beauty. Because I was a celebrated personality, I used to travel all over in my airplane. While traveling, I saw a great sage named Angira. He was very ugly, and because I was very proud of my beauty, I laughed at him. Due to this sinful action, I was condemned by the great sage to assume the form of a serpent." One should note here that before being favored by Krishna, a person is always under the modes of material nature, however elevated he may be materially. Vidyadhara was a materially elevated demigod, and he was very beautiful. He also held a great material position and was able to travel all over by airplane. Yet he was condemned to become a serpent in his next life. Any materially elevated person can be condemned to an abominable species of life if he is not careful. It is a misconception that after reaching the human body, one is never degraded. Vidyadhara himself states that even though he was a demigod, he was condemned to become a serpent. But because he was touched by the lotus feet of Krishna, he immediately came to Krishna consciousness. He admitted, however, that in his previous life, he was actually sinful. A Krishna conscious person knows that he is always the servant of the servant of Krishna. He is most insignificant, and whatever good he does is by the grace of Krishna and the spiritual master.
It's a beautiful meditation. What is that? Okay, this whole story of Vidyadhara, everybody understood. He was traveling by aeroplane. He was very handsome and saw some great sage Angira. Angira is there in many pastimes, Chitrakirtu pastime with Angira. So Angira is not very beautiful, and seeing him, he started laughing and made fun of his ugliness. And he was condemned by the sage, you know, to become a serpent. And, you know, serpent is by nature envious, jealous of other person. And then what happened? Under the modes of elevated person may be so elevated, he can be any time. Padam yat vipadam. We can be degraded down to any species, and he was condemned to become a serpent. The Prabhupada is saying any material elevated person can be condemned. So we know we are in danger. We should not be very proud or comfortable. Abominable species, if you're not devotees, is therefore very careful. Akrishna, there's a beautiful line. Pallavi, you read that line. Akrishna conscious person. Oh, she's not there now, I think. Yeah, children's. Yes, Shobha Mata, you read this line, a Krishna conscious person.
A Krishna conscious person knows that he is always the servant of Krishna. He is most insignificant. And whatever good he does is by the grace of Krishna and the spiritual master.
Yes, that's it. Okay, yes, Prabhuji, continue.
The demigod Vidyadhara continued to speak to Sri Krishna, "Because I was very proud of the exquisite beauty of my body," he said, "I derided the ugly features of the great sage Angira. He cursed me for my sin and I became a snake. Now I consider that this curse by the sage was not at all a curse. It was a great benediction for me. Had he not cursed me, I would not have assumed the body of a serpent and would not have been kicked by your lotus feet and thus freed from all material contamination.
Yes, so this is a benediction curse. Generally, great sages, when they curse, like Narada curse, Nalakuvera Manigriva, for the benediction. The great sage Angira, they don't feel bad for anybody. They do good only. So the curse is always a benediction. Yeah, continue.
In material existence, four things are very valuable: to be born in a decent family, to be very rich, to be very learned, and to be very beautiful. These are considered to be material assets. Unfortunately, without Krishna consciousness, these material assets sometimes become sources of sin and degradation. Despite Vidyadharaj being a demigod and having a beautiful body, he was condemned to the body of a snake due to pride. A snake is considered to be the most cruel and envious living entity. But those who are human beings and are envious of others are considered to be even more vicious than snakes. The snake can be subdued or controlled by charming mantras and herbs. But a person who is envious cannot be
controlled by anyone.
Cannot be controlled by anyone.
Okay, so now because he behaved like an envious person, he got a body of a snake. Okay, and Prabhupada says, okay, snake you can control by herbs, but this fellow, human beings, when they become envious, are even more dangerous. So these are all assets of life, you know, Janma, Sharira, Shruta, Shri. But if you become proud, then they are dangerous. They can cause our degradation. Okay, my dear Lord Vidyadhara.
My dear Lord, Vidyadhara continued. Now, since I think I have become freed from all kinds of sinful activity, I am asking your permission to return to my abode, the heavenly planet. This request indicates that persons who are attached to fruitive activities, desiring promotion to the comforts of higher planetary systems, cannot achieve their ultimate goal of life without the sanction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita that the less intelligent want to achieve material benefits and therefore worship different kinds of demigods. But they actually get the benediction from the demigods through the permission of Lord Vishnu or Krishna. Demigods have no power to bestow material profit. Even if one is attached to material benediction, he can worship Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and ask him. Krishna is completely able to give even material benediction. There is a difference, however, in asking material benediction from the demigods and from Krishna. Dhruva Maharaj worshipped the Supreme Personality of Godhead for material benediction, but when he actually achieved the favor of the Supreme Lord and saw him, he was so satisfied that he refused to accept any material benediction. The intelligent person doesn't ask favors from or worship the demigods. He directly becomes Krishna conscious. And if he has any desire for material benefit, he asks Krishna, not the demigods.
Okay, so he doesn't ask the demigod. I just want to finish this Leela in 1 or 2 minutes. Because I'm asking permission to go back, and Prabhupada says, yes, without the blessing of Krishna, you cannot even get a material benefit. Even the devatas have no power to give anything. They have to ask permission from Krishna. Okay. But if you directly ask Krishna, that is better. Because then you lose the desire also for material desires also go away. Yeah, just 2 paragraphs. Vidyadhara awaiting permission.
Vidyadhar, awaiting permission of Krishna to return to the heavenly planets, said, now because I am touched by your lotus feet, I am relieved from all kinds of material pangs. You are the most powerful of all mystics. You are the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. You are the master of all the devotees. You are the provider of the planetary systems, and therefore I am asking your permission. you may accept me as fully surrendered unto you. I know very well that persons who are constantly engaged in chanting your holy name attain release from all sinful reactions, and certainly persons who are fortunate enough to be personally touched by your lotus feet are freed. Therefore, I am sure that I am now relieved from the curse of the Brahmana simply by being touched by your lotus feet.
So, Krishna, touched by Krishna's lotus feet, are constantly engaged in chanting your holy name. Correct? You become free from all sinful reactions. Yes, in this way?
In this way, Vidyadhara got permission from Lord Krishna to return to his home in the higher planetary system. After receiving this honor, he began to circumambulate the Lord. And after offering his respectful obeisances unto him, he returned to his heavenly planet.
Thus Nand Maharaj also became
relieved from the imminent danger of being devoured by the snake.
Hari Bol. So we read one more Leela today, Vidyadhara Leela. Okay. Thanks, everybody. No, Prabhuji, I think that's will become 10:30. We touched our time. Now let me thank everybody for joining us. Hare Krishna Shobha Mataji, Vandana Mataji, Hare Krishna Gaurav, Chaitanya,
Hare Krishna sir,
Rajula, Hare Krishna Pradesh, Hare Krishna Sushma Mataji,
Hare Krishna,
Manita Sushma together today, Hare Krishna Vikas,
Hare Krishna sir,
Hare Krishna. Chaitanya, okay, we read. Dr. Pramod, Hare Krishna, Dr. Ji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. You have a loud mic. I don't know how. A nice mic you have. Voice is very strong.
Yeah.
Shobha Mataji, he was with you there, Salala?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Yes.
He was professor in college here.
Oh.
PhD, that's why he's doctor.
Doctor. And then we have Rohan, Hare Krishna Rohan. Okay. Sri Ram, yeah. Radha Mataji, Hare Krishna Radha Mataji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rohan and everyone.
Yeah, thank you everybody. Vanchai Kalpataru Vibhasya, Kripa Sindhu Vibhasya.
Japati Nanam, Pabunya Bhavuna, Vishnu Bhavuna.
Thank you, everybody. Hare Krishna.
Hare Prabhupada
ki.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Jai. Krishna Bhukki.
Jai.
Hare Namanishtha Prabhu ki.
Jai.
Jai.